Guess we're done here.
Hey. How you doing, buddy? Keep moving, Scabber. Nothing to see here. If you're hungry, you can grab a quick bite of power noodles. Just talk to the robot. Wait there. Hey, come on.
Of an animal you've got there.
Heads up. Hold position.
Swatters, right here. Best skull bashes in the Commonwealth.
Diamond City surplus. Everything
hey,
you need.
Ain't no shame in taking the occasional cap. Solomon can hook you up.
We got small arms, long arms, ammunition.
Self-prescribed chems, as recommended by me, myself, and I.
Swatter, 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 swing, swatter.
Hi there.
Travis.
Don't break my stuff if you don't mind. This radio station, you'll notice there aren't any other ones. So,
Tats, buff out, stim packs, jet, everything to even you out.
Park the car in the yard? How about I hammer you in the heart with a haymaker?
Who needs a haircut? Everyone needs a haircut. Step up.
Read all about it. The shit replaces people.
Hey, Piper.
Glad you dropped by. You holding up, Blue?
Why are you calling me that?
Because you're a vault dweller. I know you're not wearing the blue jumpsuit right now, but the Pip-Boy and the fish-out-of-water look... dead giveaways. So here's the deal. I want an interview. Your life story in print. I think it's time Diamond City had a little outside perspective on the Commonwealth. You do that, and I'll tell you what. I'll come with you. Watch your back while you get used to the world above ground.
what kind of interview is this gonna be?
I ask you who you are, get your opinion on life out there, and maybe load up a few tough questions and keep it interesting. What do you say?
All right, Piper. I'm in.
Good. Let's get down to business. So, I know you're from a vault. How would you describe your time on the inside?
My family and I were frozen. I didn't spend much time in the vault.
Wait, they boxed you up in a fridge? The whole time? Are you saying you were alive before the war?
Yes. I'm over 200 years old.
Oh my god. The man out of time. So, you've seen the Commonwealth, Diamond City. How does it compare to your old life?
You're all living in rusty shacks, killing each other. My god, the smell.
Okay. Well, that's gonna be a fun one to quote. Now, I already know you're looking for your son, Sean. Do you suspect the Institute was involved in his kidnapping?
I don't know.
No one ever does. That's what makes them so scary. For the last part of our interview, I'd like to do something different. I want you to make a statement to Diamond City directly. The threat of kidnapping is all but ignored in the Commonwealth. Everyone wants to pretend it just doesn't happen. What would you say to someone out there who's lost a loved one but might be too scared or too numb to the world to look for them?
No matter how much you want to give up, don't. You have to have hope that you'll see them again. Or at least, that you'll know the truth.
A strong note to end on, Blue. Thanks. That's everything. It's gonna take some time to put this all together, but I think your story is gonna give Diamond City plenty to talk about. Anyway, I agreed to come with you, right? Watch your back? Just say the word when you're ready. I can't wait to see where the story goes next. Nothing stays hidden forever. At least, not if I have my say.
Piper.
Head my way?
You sure you want to travel with me?
Well, it's that, or get back to writing the paper. I guess the paper can wait.
You know what? Never mind.
You know where to find me. Never thought a reporter could consider themselves a success until someone threatened their life. Me? I'm very successful.
Heads up. How you doing, buddy? Stay safe, buddy.
Maybe constantly trying to kill us, but the Commonwealth never lacks for excitement.
Piper.
Heading my way?
Sure, let's go.
Will do.
Look alive.
Shoot. Something to say?
Your thoughts?
Let me know if there's anything I can do to lighten the load, or, you know, if you need anything proofread.
I was just wondering where you and I stand.
Well, things aren't bad. Because believe me, you'd know if they were. But I suppose we could be doing better.
That was all I had.
Okay.
Look alive.
Just like... Let me know. What you got for me? Sure, take a peek. Big, loud, full of corrupt officials and brown-nosing citizens.
I ain't telling you how to pick your friends, but Pipe is kind of a troublemaker.
Hey, swatter, swatter, swatter can hit! Boom!
This whole market smells like noodles and blood and shampoo and ammo.
The latest hairstyles from the upper stand.
Chemicare cares about you, all your medicinal needs.
Excuse me, you got a moment? Tell me, are you worried about the possible infiltration of Diamond City's ruling elite by synths?
Yeah, Piper, I am. But I ain't buying your lousy newspaper.
Oh, well...
Hey,
Thanks.
Who wants to look beautiful?
I guess.
Hairstyles from across the Commonwealth.
You're getting pretty chummy with that reporter, huh? But careful. The mayor's got it in for her.
Beat it.
Cook won't be bothering Darcy anymore.
Good. I knew you could handle him. Oh, and I managed to scrape together what I promised. Here. It was worth it to get Darcy back. So, what happened? Did he give you any trouble?
Nothing I couldn't handle.
Okay. I don't care what you had to do. Just as long as he leaves Darcy alone from now on. Anyway, thanks for your help. I'll, see you around.
What are you gonna do now?
I don't know. Things just got crazy. Can't believe he's actually dead.
I'm only here for a drink.
I don't like you, and I don't like your radio. What you gonna do about it?
Yeah!
But what's this about?
Oh, what's wrong? Not so tough once you're not on the air.
You tell him.
Can't you just leave me alone?
Maybe I don't like your little radio program. What you have to say about that?
Oh! I'm only here for a drink.
I don't like you, and I don't like your radio. What you gonna do about it?
Oh!
I want it so much more from my life than this.
Maybe I don't like your little radio program. What you have to say about that?
Excuse me.
Don't let my husband drag you into any of his nonsense.
What's this about?
Oh,
hey there, pal.
It's not so tough once you're not on the air.
You need to grow a spine, pal.
I didn't ask for this. I'm just trying to have a drink.
I have no idea what I did to deserve this. I just wish they'd go away.
Why not stand up to them?
No! I mean, no! That would be bad. With these men, it could turn violent.
Nothing will change unless you make it happen.
It's not that bad. I can just deal with this.
Don't worry. I've got your back.
Well, if you think it would work...
We're right behind you.
Hey.
Get lost.
I mean... Hi. Again. Hi? Hi.
Oh. Okay. That's...
We're drinking
well,
here?
That's enough.
Oh, so I'm sorry.
What's the
you
thing
say
least likely to make me blind?
I said that's
Piper.
Enough.
You
Leave
have
me
finally
alone.
Decided to come publish what the latest tale of
Look
heroism.
Look at you. Let me think about that for a second.
Heroism.
I don't think
What'd
so.
What'd you do this time, Vadim?
I mean
you
it.
Will not believe.
Leave me alone.
So,
Sounds like you were thinking about saying, or else. Were you, Travis? Were you going to say,
else.
Or else?
Vadim, please.
I'm wondering
stop.
What comes
now.
After that.
Can I just have
What
a
you going to do, little man?
I'll beat you up!
Big mistake, Travis. I'm gonna destroy you and your friend here.
Why am I doing this?
Ah, God, my jaw. Bullshit, man. Just bullshit.
If we're gonna dance, let's dance.
Hey, Travis.
Whoa.
Get lost.
Don't know you, Scaver.
I think that went well. Ready for next part of foolproof plan?
The last part wasn't so foolproof.
You are alive, Travis is alive, everything is fine. And next part is simple. You have seen Scarlet, yes? She has worked here for some time. Now, I am just simple bartender, but I see things. I see how Travis looks at her, and I see that sometimes she looks at him. If someone who was not her employer suggests that she go spend time with Travis, it might do him some good.
I could have a chat with her.
Yes, I know. This is why I'm telling you. Just do whatever it takes to get her to agree to see Travis, and this will all be worth it. And you and I... Never talked about this, all right?
Whatever you're gonna ask, I don't know anything about it.
Paul and I have a child. I regret a lot of things, but not my little Pete.
You have marvelous bone structure. Stop by the mega surgery sometime.
The Institute? I ain't scared of them.
No.
Really? I swear.
Hi. Oh, wow. You're tall.
Miss?
I'm on a break right now.
Can I ask you something personal?
It's about Travis.
Travis? Really? Did he mention me? I heard about the fight. Travis was... well, he was brave.
Maybe. Why don't you go ask him?
Well, I don't know. I mean, I've definitely noticed him. Maybe... No, I couldn't just go over there.
Look, Travis is a nice guy. I can tell that you like him. And I think he likes you. Just go talk to him.
Okay, I will. I'll go see him now. Thanks.
Okay. I usually don't. This is why.
Travis.
Don't break my stuff if you don't mind.
Hey, Scarlett.
I'm on a break right now.
Okay. I usually don't. This is why.
Hey, Scarlett.
I'm on a break right now.
Hey.
What can I do?
Piper.
What's going on?
Your thoughts?
I'd rather know an ugly truth than a sweet lie.
Oh, nothing.
Okay.
This radio station, you'll notice there aren't any other ones. So...
Heads up. Moving out.
Can do.
Beer and my slippers after this shift. That's all I ask.
I knew it. He was up to no good, and look what's happened now. You've got to help. I can't do it. You've got to help me.
What are you talking about?
I am talking about Vadim. They took him. Those men, the ones that messed with Travis, they came back. Said Vadim owed them money, that they had a deal. He wouldn't pay, and then they grabbed him and said that they would make him pay. And then they just dragged him out.
You have to do something. Please tell me you can do something.
Do you know where they took him?
No, I don't know. He's the one that has always dealt with them. I've tried to avoid them. Travis might know. You should ask him, please. Hurry. I don't want anything to happen to Vadim.
I want to be left alone.
You need something, Scabber?
Hey there. What's going on?
Have you seen Vadim? He was grabbed at the dugout, and Yefim thought you might know where Bull took him.
What? That's not a funny joke. Like, at all.
I'm not joking around, Travis. This is serious. I really do need your help.
Wait. Really? Oh. Oh, man. Wow. Is this... This is because of what happened, isn't it? It's my fault.
No, Travis. This is between Vadim and those men. It's not your fault.
But if I hadn't gotten into that fight with them, maybe this wouldn't have happened.
Don't do that to yourself. All we can do now is figure out how to make this right.
Look, I don't really... I mean... I don't have a lot of friends. If Vadim is missing, or in trouble, or whatever, then I'm gonna help get him back.
It's probably gonna be dangerous. I expect things will get ugly.
I'm not stupid. I know that. I've heard enough to know they're probably holed up at the old Beantown Brewery. We've got to go in there, show them we mean business, and then we can bring Vadim back, and everything will be okay. Right? I'll get a gun, and I'll meet you there. We'll settle this.
I'm on a break right now. Go on.
Hey, Nat.
You won't believe what's in the next issue. Just you wait.
Everything outside the wall ain't safe. That's just how it is.
Guess they're not interested in sharing, huh? Carry something if you need to.
Heads up.
You say the word. Take a look.
Oh, thank God. You're here.
So this is it.
Odds are if they've got Vadim, he's inside. We're gonna be okay, right?
You know anything else about this brewery?
Not really. I mean, I think it's where their little gang hides out. There shouldn't be too many of them.
Good. We get the drop on them. This should be a piece of cake.
Any last-minute advice? I've never done anything like this.
I go in first, and you stay behind me. Watch my back.
Okay. Whatever you say.
Whatever is making that smell needs to seek medical attention immediately.
You were so dead! Sure you saw something?
Hey, something's out there.
Failure!
in the way otherwise. Hell of a setup just to get people sauced.
Hey there.
Thank you. I didn't know if anyone would come. I thought perhaps this is the end. Thank you. Thank you. You are a true friend.
Are there more of them? Are they gonna come after you again?
No, no. This was best they could do. You got them. These idiots had caps and chems just lying around. They did not notice when I filled my pockets. You deserve what I took. Ah, and Travis, I am surprised to see you here.
Hey, Vadim. I'm glad you're safe.
How did you get roped into this?
I wasn't forced or anything. I wanted to help.
You are full of surprises, my friend.
Hey there.
Man, what a day, huh?
Hey, listen. I wanted to say thanks. This has been... well, it's been crazy. But I've learned a lot, I think.
What are you gonna do now?
Well, that's what I've been thinking about. After all this, I think about the things that had me worried so much, and it just seems silly, you know? Like, was I really that worried about just being on the radio? That's nothing compared to being beaten up, shot at. I can do so much more. And I need to. Anyway. Thanks again. I owe you.
Thank you.
There we go. Hell yeah. Thank you.
You are so dead!
Better in our hands anyway. What was that? Mr. Handy, a feather duster, and say, what, 100 years, and this place would be right as rain.